What we're about to see is British comedy. You may not understand all of it at first because it's more sophisticated than what we're used to.
That man is wearing a dress.
Exactly.
Well, I can't wait any longer, but we're just going to have to watch the tape.
Ooh, look at that. Ooh, look at that.
Posh! I've a run in my stocking.
Yes, Prime Minister.
Made in America cannot just be a marketing. It's got to stand for something.
What's wrong, Dad?
This dang rock busted up my rototiller. Rototiller.
A rock? That is no rock. This is an arrowhead.
An Indian arrowhead. I led a field trip once to the Museum of Texas Cultures. A girl swallowed one just like this by Miss. She thought it was a rock, too.
We learned in school you don't call them cocks anymore. You call them sex partner instead of
Bobby.
Dad, what is that?
Some old Indian thing.
What's it for?
Well, I don't know much about Indians, but I do know tools. And if I had to guess, I'd say you jam one of these in the back of a white man's skull, twist the handle like so, and then your blood runs out through the hole here. Yeah, that's what it's for. Well, I'm gonna get to the bottom of this. I'd hate to use a tool.
What the fuck?
Sorry, Shug. Dale's...
I'm not looking for Dale, I'm looking for...
Dale. Corn!
Nancy has a therapeutic massage today. For her migraines.
Listen, I found this Indian, native Indian thing in my yard, and I was wondering if you knew what it was.
It's a tool used for straightening the shaft of an arrow.
In a pinch, though, you could brain it into someone's jamming stem, right?
Yes.
Well, yeah, sure, I guess.
A treasure such as this is priceless to my people.
Really? What do you suppose it's worth?
$50.
$50, huh?
Well, food for thought.
Sign a petition to legalize hemp?
What's hemp?
It's a cheap and durable source of fibers that can be used for making clothing, rope, and paper.
Typical government overregulation. Why wouldn't they legalize this stuff?
Well, because, you know, it's basically...
marijuana.
The volcano erupted so suddenly that the village and everyone in it were instantly encased in lava, creating a snapshot, if you will, of daily life at that exact moment. And when we archaeologists go and develop that snapshot, believe me, no one in a one is smiling. See?
Deal.
Excuse me, Professor. I'm Hank.
The artifact guy, yeah. You don't have to hit pound. So, for me.
Well, I got head, and this here's a straightener. So, what do you think they're worth?
Well, the head, that's garbage. Here, let me throw it away for you, it's on me.
How about... what do you think they're worth? Or worth?
That's worth loincloth for, say, a new... What's a crotch-sized piece of leather go for these days?
I certainly know.
Can't be more than $10, right?
No. But an Indian friend of mine said it was sacred.
Let me explain something to you, Mr. Hill. To the Native Americans, everything is sacred. The sun, the dirt, the sun, the dun. You want to pay me for the dirt you've been breathing since you came in? That's sacred, too.
$10.
Got it. It's all there. Okay.
You have no right to sell those artifacts, Hank. This home belongs to the both of us.
What are you so upset about? I got $10 for some junk that Bobby would have just ended up swallowing.
Those objects were cultural. They could have expanded Bobby's mind. And I, for one, want my son's brain to swell up as big as it'll go.